Welcome to the Prep Athletics Podcast. This is Corey Heights.
Some battles. I'm not sure if they got us. If they did, maybe.
So you will get better as a player during that year.
So it was kind of exciting. Like, oh yeah, somebody wants me.
But Mike, why aren't they trusting you? Why aren't they trusting the prep school coaches based on your track record? And who would they be trusting instead of you?
I'll stick up for them. Because of COVID, they're confused. They don't know what's the NCAA going to let us do. You know, a lot of guys want to see people live. Now they can't. All right. They can't see this class live. And they can't see the juniors in the spring live either. Okay. Which hurts. Okay. They don't know. All right. The NCAA says these kids who are playing 20 and 25 games this year, and that includes some of my guys, can come back and repeat the year in college. I don't know if I agree with that. That kills the class. Then there's the transfer portal, which we don't have a lot of transfers from St. Andrews, but I had a guy last year transfer, and he's playing right away. So that benefited him. Not sure I agree with that, okay? I think the guy still should sit out and really think about why am I transferring, okay? So the college coaches have those three things working, but then I think they make a big mistake. And I can say it. I've been an AAU coach. I think they put too much stock in the AAU coaches. I can say it because I've coached AAU.
Right.
And it's not the same. And I'll defend the AAU coach also. You know, you might have a practice a week and again in tournaments. Some programs have two. These guys who do an unbelievable job, no doubt. But AAU is for exposure. It's for exposure. Some programs do develop kids. Don't get me wrong. It's for exposure and competition because you do have a lot of very good players. But they're not handling the academic piece, the social piece. They're not with the kid and family day to day. They're not getting the picture. They're not getting the picture that you're getting. And that's huge because these college guys are talking about character and will he fit on campus? Will he do that? And a lot of these guys they're listening to, they don't know. Because they're not there. And we're on campus. I know if a kid can make it in the dorm. You know, I know if a kid has money for the weekend, you know, field trips, you know, how involved are the parents? I know that. All right. Some of these, some of the AU guys, and including me when I was an AU coach, you don't get that feel. And the games are different. The games are different. You got, you know, knock on wood at St. Andrews, we're going to pack the gym every game. We're packing it. And I've been to EYBL. That's the closest you're going to get to the actual real college basketball. High school, college, very similar. AAU, NBA, very similar. Styles of play, very similar. So if I'm a college coach, I have to see the kid play at the high school level too. And that means you need to trust the high school coach or even more so the prep school coach.
Right.
You need to trust those guys. And they're not right now. And they need us more than ever. Now, that's not everybody. That's not everybody. But I wish more of them would. I got one guy, a junior college coach. I talked to him yesterday. We did a Zoom with one of my guys. He's like, he's in. Let me know. Hasn't seen him play yet. But I've sent five other kids there. All five were tremendous. He got to the national tournament with those guys. And I'm talking over a 10-year period. And he placed those guys at least at the Division II level. Moved on. So it's a trust factor.